provision of God is your portion. The provision of God is your portion. Lift up your hands, everybody. Yes.
Yes.
That's as Abraham was about to start his son. God said, Abraham, look to the right.
Yes.
You see, every vision that is of God, every vision that is of God, he adds or he makes a provision for the vision.
Yes.
Every vision, every agenda.
Yes.
Some of you are married and you are not finding happiness in your marriage. Sometimes, sister, my brother, I have seen people in life that are so poor that poverty smells around them. But today, by the provision and the grace of God,
yes,
they are one of the multi-billion people in the world.
Yes.
And today, I see the grace coming upon you.
Amen.
I said, I see the grace coming Amen. Upon you. 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 Somebody, can you make a joyful noise? Make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise. Sacrifice for God.
Amen.
Apart from Jesus, you can never sacrifice anything to please God. They use lambs and sheep. He was going to sacrifice his son. But by faith, as he believed in the prophetic direction of God, God said, Abraham, don't kill your son. You have reached your destination.
Yes.
And in the struggle you're going through,
I receive that.
In the mountains you are climbing,
I receive
in the valleys you're going through, in the mess you're going through, the provision of God is upon you today. The provision of God is upon you today. The grace of God is upon you. 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 And I see you lift up your hands. Lift up your hands and say, I want to advise you from today that the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Yes.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Mm-hmm.
In all your ways.
Mm-hmm.
Can I hear some Bible? In all your ways. In all your ways. Oh, somebody say, I could not reach. In all your ways. I said, in all your ways, you are free to your destination, my sister. You are free to your destination, my brother. You are free to your destination, my brother. You are free to your destination, my sister. You are free to your destination. 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 Lift up your hands and say, ah! Lift up your hands and say, ah! Like a poor person who gets
powerful.
A poor person who gets up in the morning by faith. Even though he doesn't know how he's going to be rich.
Ah.
But the Bible says confessions brings possessions. That is why some of you have a tendency of confessing negative things about yourself. You have been confessing that they will fire you. And all too soon they fire you, say man can't. I said it, they will fire me. Let me tell you something. Job was a very, very, very rich person. But when trouble came upon Job, he said something which was very wrong.
Yes.
He said, that which I feared has come.
Oh.
That which I feared has come upon me. Anything you fear in your life, today I stand in the blood of Jesus. And I cancel, I cancel, I cancel, I cancel. I cancel. in your life. The things you believe in your life, that is what comes upon you. If you believe that the GPS will take you to that destination, you are poor, but you believe that the mighty God that has the global power to do all things to exceed the imagination of man. You believe that this God, even though you are a nobody, he can make you a somebody. If you don't believe this, don't listen to anybody. Don't listen to naysayers.
Yes.
Don't listen to negative things they are saying about you. I said I can do all things.
Yes.
You 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 can do all things.
Yes.
Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. If you believe, you don't know the direction for the destination, and you have given the right address to the GPS, follow it. Until you hear the word, you have reached your destination. Don't turn to the left and then turn to the right. Sometimes some of the road signs, they have a tendency to give you a false alarm. Are you going to Woodbridge? But sometimes you get to this area and you see one of the signs saying Woodbridge, but it doesn't really need to really take you to Yes. Sometimes the direction tells you too early. And sometimes just in life, as you're praying about marriage, there is a possibility of some road that says Woodbridge. You take it. And you realize that you are a human being. Now you have gone to the bush and taken a monkey. And it's not going to talk to you. It's not going to talk to you. It's a wrong direction. They will be making free. They will be making free. Say the same thing, free. Let me hear you say free. Let me hear you say free. Some of us are men.
Powerful message.
Some of us are men. Because we followed the direction too early. The direction we were going to Woodbridge. But when I got to somewhere and I saw Woodbridge, and you follow the direction. You see, Adam. God, Bible says Adam, God created every beast in the bush. God created two of them. Only Adam, God made him alone. The Bible said Adam was looking for a suitable mate. In a jungle full of snakes, dogs, pigs, frogs, goat, amen. Adam was in the bush looking for a suitable mate in the jungle. How can you look for a suitable mate as a human being in the jungle? And let me tell you, this world we are living in, it is a nice world, but we are living in the jungle.
Yes.
If you make mistake and you get a wrong woman, I don't mean you. If you make mistake and you get a wrong man, say, I don't mean you. Even though you are a human, or maybe you are a sheep, a very humble one. If you go for a goat, when the sheep is sleeping, you hear me, because you are giving the wrong direction. But today I said you will get to your destination. I said you will get to your destination. 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 Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen.
Preach on.
If you have given the right address to the GPS, take your time very slowly and methodically. Let it take you there. If you get to the destination, you will not know, because you should always remember that before you didn't know the address.
Yes.
If you rush to get there, you will lost. But if you get there, the GPS will tell you you have reached
your destination.
I tell you have reached
your destination.
I tell you have reached. I tell you have reached. You have reached. Lift up your hands, everyone. Lift up your hands.
Receive it.
It's okay. Lift up your hands, everybody. So many of you, I see that you are taking a wrong turn. And as I'm speaking, God is telling you through this message that you can make a legal U-turn. I hear some of you, your GPS, telling you that rerouting. You can make get away. He didn't say illegal. He said you can make a legal
U-turn.
Some of you, the business you are doing, you have to make a U-turn.
Jesus.
The kind of friends you are hanging out with, you gotta make a U-turn.
Yes, yes.
The kind of places and the people you have been talking to. Some of you have been dealing with the wrong people in your life.
Yes.
And today I am advising you, God said, follow him. You have lost. You have to make a legal U-turn.
Amen.
I wish I could call you and tell you that where you are now, you have to make a legal
U-turn.
Yes. The reason why you think you have gone very far, but you haven't gotten anywhere, because the God that is the master of all, who is the creator of the universe,
yes,
who has the blueprint and the master plan of this earth,
Jesus,
your agenda in life doesn't fit into his purpose.
Yes.
The reason why God said, David is a man after my own heart, and it's not just a heart. God said, David is a man after my own plan. Because David followed the direction of God.
Amen.
Most of us, we have missed our way.
That's right.
But the Bible says, listen to the language. If the people that are called by my name will humble themselves and now try and make a legal U-turn. If the people that are called by my name will humble themselves,
yes,
because the direction you are going, you are lost. It says make a legal U-turn. So if you will humble yourself and obey and make a legal U-turn, he says, I, the Lord, I will hear your voice from heaven. GPS is controlled by a global position, which is high over in the sky. So he says, if the people that are called by my name will humble themselves,
yes,
and they will set my face in prayer, and they will repent from their wicked ways, I, the Lord, I will hear their voice in heaven. I will hear their voice from heaven. I will forgive them,
yes,
and heal their land. I said today, if you really want your land to be healed, if you want to hear you have reached your destination, you must make a legal U-turn. Everybody rise up on your feet.
Okay.